Meet Boy. He lives in Anchorage, Alaska. But last year, when he was just a few months old, his owner, Jamie Bolton, got the kind of scare all dog owners dread. He'd been playing outside in the frigid outdoors with her daughter and a friend.
The puppy dog had come back inside, and the children had come back in, and Bowie started vomiting. The only way I can describe it is like a black tar that he had been vomiting. So as I'm cleaning it up, I see little remnants of packaging, and I looked and I realized that it was the packaging from the hand warmers. So I called the pet poison control hotline, and they did some intake on Bowie.
Pet Poison Helpline, we are a 24/7 animal poison control center. So this is what we do when an animal has gotten into something that it shouldn't. And our role is to evaluate that case and determine whether or not that object, the toxin, potential toxin that that pet got into could cause poisoning. So the first thing that we do is we get information about that patient. So we learned that he was a puppy, we got his breed, his age, his weight.
They immediately recommended that I get him over to pet emergency.
And in Bowie's case, he was already vomiting. And that's a big indication because vomiting is the first sign of iron poisoning. And so then our next step is to talk to the veterinarian on his case and explain to them what we expect to see, what iron poisoning can cause in a dog, what sort of tests that they should be running, and most importantly, what sort of treatment they should be doing for Bowie so we can give him the best prognosis possible.
This is the x-ray from another dog who'd eaten hand warmers.
All veterinarians get some training in toxicology in vet school, but this is not necessarily a large part of their curriculum. So it's really important for veterinarians to have an expert resource that they can rely on.
And they were really concerned about, the damage, to his organs, but to like the mucous membranes as well, especially given his size. My husband contacted me and said, just given his size and how much he's ingested, you just need to be prepared for the fact that he doesn't come home from this. They kept him overnight, and then the next day I received a call from the vet at Pet Emergency, and they said it actually looked really good because we had contacted the Pet Poison Control Hotline so quickly.
So in all cases of poisoning, time is of the essence. If we can get to those patients as soon as they got into something, the chances of them having a good prognosis are much, much greater.
If your pet gets in trouble, look online for petpoisonhelpline.com. A consultation costs $65, which includes the initial diagnosis, and then they make follow-up calls to monitor your pet's progress.
It's also going to be the most economical. If we can treat patients before they get very sick, that's going to be a much cheaper treatment. Some of the calls that we get, we can very safely determine that that pet does not need to go into an emergency clinic.
Thankfully, Boy's story has a happy ending.
So he recovered. He's wonderful. He just celebrated his first birthday last month.
Like Boy, lots of pets get into things they shouldn't. And the holidays present special challenges for pet owners.
First of all, it's food. Often things like chocolate or maybe toffees, nuts, things of that nature. The other thing that I worried about are certain holiday plants. So now you may be thinking poinsettia,
right?
But actually poinsettias get a kind of a bad rap. They're really not as toxic as they've been made out to be. But the holiday plants that I really worry about are one, the yew branches. So yew is a type of evergreen. And the other one are lilies. So lilies are particularly toxic to cats. The third is dogs in particular getting into people's purses or backpacks. You can find all sorts of things in a purse. You can find baggies of medications. You can find chewing gum that might have xylitol in it, which is a sugar substitute. You can find things like cigarettes or nicotine patches.
So if your little friend gets into trouble, remember the Pet Poison Helpline is available 24/7. For Pet Pals TV, I'm Steve Schweitzer. But for this story, I'm giving the final word to Jamie.
Anything that is a foreign substance that's not intended for dogs, you absolutely should look. Don't hesitate to call the Poison Control Helpline. I mean, my goodness, it's better safe than sorry, right?